All right, I'm Bakpak Durden. I use they, them pronouns. To explain my style, it would be to say it's kind of like hyper-realistic, surrealistic, conceptual art that makes you feel your feelings. Yeah, and my preferred medium is whatever I have at my disposal, I suppose. Working with the 49507 project, I'm most excited about how intentional the whole program is. And I mean, the painting is, that's gonna be something else, but I'm just excited about how much is being put in before the painting happens. I'm excited about what's happening right now. My typical process for creating a mural, it depends on where it's at and who it's for. So I typically like to reference the community it's going to be a part of and be very honest and intentional about the subject matter. Going into this mural and this whole process has been different largely because of the amount of listening sessions and how wide the, how many different types of people are involved with the listening sessions, from young people to older people, I should say. And everyone's differing perspectives make it very interesting. But in terms of trying to figure out what I'm gonna paint, I have no idea. And it honestly makes it even more difficult because of what's happening right now in Grand Rapids. How do you try to help actively heal a community that needs healing? You know what I mean? A few ways off the dome, ways to better our communities, our Black communities, be more resources. And oftentimes the resources come with strings. And also oftentimes resources get taken by folks that have better access to those resources, that may be from out of the area that's the focus of those resources. Affordability, whether it's housing, I'm gonna say water, shit, good water, internet should be free. I don't think I want to say job training because y'all can hold on to that sometimes. I need you to come alive. Yeah. I need you to come alive. Yeah. I need you to come. I'm like, hey, got the people on the way.